This is the story of Kevin and Sune Gopal. They wanted to immigrate to Australia in 2021 during the COVID pandemic. They were approved for 491 visas in Australia, but they could not travel to Australia to find their jobs, so they had to do it from a distance, and they found the job finding extremely difficult. So when they came to us, what they experienced was what many other people experience even now. This was during the COVID pandemic, like I said. They came to us in July 2021. And by September 2021, they both found their jobs, they got their travel exemption, and they traveled to Australia. And they found their jobs from a distance. Now, when we start working with people, we give them a questionnaire to fill out, to initially see what the situation is so that we can recommend the big steps or the next steps. And I'll show you that questionnaire. I'll give you a link to it. And that's where you can start if you want our help as well. One of the questions we ask in that questionnaire is, if you have started applying for jobs already, what kind of experiences or feedback, if any, have you had? So Kevin said, just all negative. Sune said, it seems like networking is the way to get a job in Adelaide, but efforts to network on LinkedIn hasn't come too much. Facebook groups have been lively and people are helpful, but nothing related to possible jobs have come up. Everyone we spoke to said we have to be in the country first before we will get jobs. We have applied for many jobs using Seek and Indeed, but don't get any interviews. We did have our CVs professionally done, as well as LinkedIn. Now, if you're watching this, then you are probably experiencing exactly the same thing. You have applied for jobs from a distance on Seek or Indeed or LinkedIn jobs, and nothing has come from it. People have said that you have to be in that country first, which is untrue. And you probably have had your CV rewritten as well, or you've done some networking and nothing has happened to this date. So this is exactly what they experienced. This is exactly what other people experience, who we are working with. And this might be the same for you. What we did together with them is took them through our Qjumper Factor VIP Masterclass. So if you're interested in that, you've got to fill out that questionnaire first. I'll give you the link at the end of this video. Then we will send you an email with a confirmation, and we will tell you the next steps. So here is what we did. We demonstrated their eligibility. Remember, they had 491 visas approved for Australia, but they couldn't find jobs. So in communicating with the employers, we had to make sure that those employers knew that they were eligible and what they were eligible for. And we had to demonstrate their value. So we used star profiles and proof of skills in action instead of just CVs with lists of skills on them, and there were no proof of their value. For them each, we found 40 targeted or more, 50 more targeted employers for each of them. Kevin had an issue in that he worked for the government in South Africa and he could not do the same in Australia because they needed residence or citizenship to work for a government organization. However, we had to repurpose his skills and found other similar employers that he could target in Australia that he could work for as well. So once we did that, we implemented the direct approach strategy with both of them. That means once we knew who these employers were, what they wanted, and how to get in front of them, we went to these employers directly, and that gave them initial visibility, which is amazing because it means that they had 15 to 40% success rate, and there they started to get responses from employers immediately. Then we also helped them build a magic 100 audience each, and that increased their visibility from people inside those targeted employers. Now, that resulted in shoulder taps for both of them. They did not need to apply for jobs online. They both got approached by employers and could actually choose the offers that they were happy with. And they landed these offers from a distance without applying online. So what we did with them is our Qjumper Factor VIP Masterclass system. So first, finding the targets, defining the jobs and the requirements, finding those employers who employ someone like that, finding out what they want and how to get in front of them, creating a set of tools that display the value, and then implementing strategies to get those tools and profiles in front of those employers. And if obviously you know who these employers are and how they, what they want, and you give it straight to them, you are well presented like they were. And if you know who these employers are and can work straight with certain employers, not falling around applying online, then obviously you would be able to get clarity and have a very structured way in which to get through. And if you have tools and strategies that others don't have, you can dominate the niche like they did, and they got multiple approaches. Now, for them, you can see how small the CV is. Like we do for others, the first two bubbles here, we do all that work for them. And that means that they do not have to struggle with CVs or profiles or finding employers or finding out what these employers want, etc., and matching their skills to what employers want. We do all the work for them. And then in the last part, implementing the strategies is where they can hit the ground running with a consultant by their side, or myself sitting with them, absolutely making sure that they're implementing the strategies until they landed their jobs. This is definitely what helped them, and it helps so many others. Now, let's have a look at Sune's profile. She is in psychotherapy. She is specializes in trauma counseling, and she is just amazing in what she does. She's moved on from her original job in Australia, and I think she started her own thing, but she is amazing at what she does, obviously. And it goes to show how well they have adapted and how well they have been able to demonstrate their value to employers in terms of making sure that it's not just a list of skills on a CV, but it's actually demonstrating their real value. And then for Kevin, he is a top executive in the online space. And obviously, like I said, he couldn't work for the Australian government like he did in South Africa. So we had to find other employers for him. You can see in his profile, he is absolutely demonstrating the level at which he executes his role. And he is incredibly valuable in the Australian market at the moment. So that is their profiles. If you are in the same position, have you got your 491 visa approved, 189, 190, or are you looking for 482 visa sponsorship in Australia, and you have to do that from a distance? You need that job offer from a distance. Like so many other people, like Sune and Kevin, there are so many others who we have helped land their jobs from a distance. So here is how to get our assistance. Look below this video. There is a comment there. In the first comment or in the description on YouTube, you'll find a link to a questionnaire. That is the same questionnaire that they have filled out. And that is the questionnaire that we ask you to fill out so that we can get your information and make sure that we understand your situation so that we can recommend the next steps for you. Then watch your inbox to see the confirmation that we have received your details, and also to see the next steps that we will recommend for you. So if you're having trouble finding your job from a distance, let us help you. Just look for that link below and fill out your questionnaire quickly. I hope that Kevin and Sune's story was helpful for you. There might be other people in exactly the same position as they are, needing to find their job from a distance in their destination country. If they can do it, you're probably not that different. They've experienced exactly the same issues as you might have. So make sure that you go through and ask for help if you need to. And like them, you could potentially land your job within a few months. They have done it during the COVID period, which is probably the biggest or major recession we have seen in our lifetimes. And they, like many others, have been able to pull this off. So can you.